Friends, today we'll discuss joint family. Now, this issue of joint family is important from the point of view of currents in social issues. It can be in currents in general also. It can be useful in sociology, it can be useful in economics, it can be useful everywhere demography is involved, in anthropology of course. Firstly, you should know what is a joint family. Structurally, you know, a joint family, three conditions, there must be at least two nuclear families. Secondly, joined vertically means three generations. And thirdly, this joining is as per the rules of residence of that society. And in India, you have a unique case also when parents are dead. Two married brothers with their families living together, because the elder brother performs the role of father. The elder brother represents third generation. That way it becomes. Now, various studies have been there, particularly in the West. After Industrial Revolution, it was seen that joint families, they declined very significantly. Within a generation, within 30 years after the start of Industrial Revolution, declined. And then throughout Europe and US, wherever industrialization was taken up in large scale. And that was also shown by some initial studies that were conducted in 1950s and 60s. Recently, two studies appeared, one in Times of India, one in Hindustan Times. In the study in Times of India, they talked about joint family. In Hindustan Times, they talked about total fertility rate. In the last one decade, ironically, the statistics of 2011, they have been released only recently. I don't know how long we should take. In Hindustan Times, they showed that total fertility rate is on the decline. In Times of India, the analysis of 2011, it showed that joint family is on the rise. Seems contradictory. So the studies which were conducted in early 50s and 60s, that were also the studies when following Mahalanobis model, second plan onward, we started large-scale industrialization throughout the country. People migrated to industrial centers, leaving their homes, got a job, went back, got married, and would go back home only occasionally. At that time, the studies were conducted, and it was shown that joint family is disintegrating. The village youth is leaving, is breaking the joint family. So, is really joint family on the decline? Many studies were there. One important point was made by Dr. T. N. Madan, Professor T. N. Madan. He is Professor Emeritus, Institute of Economic Growth. He told that all the studies that we call studies of joint family, basically these are the studies of households. And household structure in India, it has fluctuated only between 4.6 and 4.7 right from 1931 till 1971. Then Professor A.M. Shah of Delhi School of Economics, University of Delhi, Department of Sociology, he conducted study in 1999, and he told that the man who left his village and who was charged with breaking joint family, actually he had created a joint family around himself. He migrated with wife, children were born, they studied or not studied, they also became adults, they also got married, they also have children. So he created a joint family around himself. If space was less in Jhugi, another Jhugi was enacted nearby. There was a basic difference in the nature of the traditional joint family and this joint family. And that is, previous joint family was patriarchal. Patriarchal means the wish or decision of head of the family was important. He would decide grandchildren, they will have books, one of them, clothes, another one, third, twice, fourth, shoes. Today's joint family is filiocentric, F-I-L-I-O. Filiocentric means wish of the children is important. Whatever they decide, it is Karta's, head of the family's headache, how he manages. Then you had analysis of National Family Health Survey 1 and 2 by J.P. Singh in 2010. He also said that these are on the decline, but again these were household survey. Family observations have been there mainly by the census. You had figures of 2011, you have also figures of 2001 with you. And this article which I am quoting, Times of India, July, it shows that 26% increase in joint families in the urban areas and 2% in the rural areas. In our book, the preliminary observations were there 3 years after the census. And that showed that joint family was on the increase in the 5 major metros, including Hyderabad. But now when all the figures are there, it showed 26% increase in urban areas throughout the country and 2% in the rural areas. Social scientists from Delhi School of Economics and from JNU School of Social Sciences, they have commented. They tell us that in rural area that 2% figure may not be exact figure, actual figure may be much more. Because in the village, size of the family is attached to the size of landholding. Division in the land means division in the family. So a number of families must have split because of that. So the actual family, number of families who became joint must be much more. And what are the reasons given? 3 major reasons are there. Firstly, that was there in 2014 also, escalating cost of land. Land is exorbitant rates are there. Commoner, even if you become, get into job in civil service throughout your life if you earn, you cannot have a home in Delhi. A decent home. Land cost is increasing too much. Secondly, psychological security. That's very important. When children are out, when they'll be back, whether anything, any mishap happened with them or not, that is psychological is very important. Social security also. What is happening today? You have a permanent servant, he may do something wrong. Instead of taking your children to school, he may take them to his home in the village. Insecurity is on the rise, that's why. Grandparents would be sincere. Economic reasons are also there, like many of the Indians. When they have their children in the US, they go there for babysitting. Because parents are sincere, they don't charge anything also. Same can be here also, particularly in the urban areas. But the fact is that joint family is on the rise and this trend will likely continue. Thank you.